You're watching UNICEF television. Cries of pain fill L'Esther Medical Center in Artibonite, the epicenter of Haiti's cholera epidemic. Almost a week after the first cases were reported, new victims continue to arrive.
Our whole family was sick with diarrhea, but our village is very far away. It's not easy to get here. We ended up having to use a motorbike taxi, but both Jackson's father and mother died along the way.
So far, over 250 deaths have been reported out of more than 3,000 confirmed cholera cases.
Since Wednesday, they had admitted more than 500 patients. For the moment, we don't have breakdown statistics, but in the hospital, I can say just from a perspective of admission, the patient I see, I can say children under 18 may represent 30 to 40% of admitted patients.
The wards of hospitals are overflowing with serious cases of the deadly waterborne bacteria. Many are being treated out in the open. Cholera causes massive and painful diarrhea that ravages the body. Left untreated, it can kill within hours. Stemming the spread of the disease is a huge challenge since many communities don't have access to clean water. Teams of Cuban doctors are helping local health authorities treat the sick with medical supplies provided by UNICEF. The organization is spearheading efforts to distribute soap, water purification tablets, and rehydration salts across the district.
It's a humanitarian crisis. Coordination is absolutely key. So, for example, UNICEF is coordinating the water and sanitation cluster, which is absolutely critical to manage cholera. So it's UNICEF that's pulling all the other organizations together in this cluster.
Haiti has not seen a cholera epidemic for more than a century, making the country extremely unprepared for the outbreak. Health organizations are working relentlessly to give information and spread awareness about the precautions people should take.
This will allow people to know how to avoid sickness, and it will reduce the numbers of infected people. Because everyone who has the knowledge passes it on to others who are not informed, and over time, we hope that the whole population will be informed so that we can contain this epidemic, while the health workers can concentrate on those who are already sick.
With proper care and treatment, most cases recover fairly quickly.
The caseload is increasing, but the death rate is actually gone down a bit, which shows, I think, the response has been quite effective. But frankly, we have been focusing mainly on the areas of high contamination. We need to go everywhere, because this is going to spread, unfortunately.
The cholera seems to have established a strong foothold in beleaguered Haiti. The influx of aid will go a long way in containing the disease. This is Priyanka Pruthi reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.